In this video, I would like to introduce a desktop app I've been working on for a few months. It's called Kunkun. And I'm so glad to share with you that it just won first place of Svelte Hack 2024 today. So what is it? Kunkun is an extensible app launcher, similar to Raycast and Offred, but it's open source, cross-platform, and designed with security in mind. I will cover the following topics in this video. Features demonstration, why I built this app, and security for extension systems. Let's take a quick look at some of its features. First of all, it is in the form of app launcher, so of course it can search for and open apps. Kunkun has many built-in commands, such as clipboard history manager, key displayer, volume controller. However, no matter how many features I implement for this app, it will never satisfy everyone. Kunkun is extensible, meaning it is tailored to your own needs. You get to decide what extensions to install or even create your own extensions. Kunkun has a public extension store where everyone can publish and share their extensions. We also have a website for the extension store. For example, this Git Skyline extension built with Vue.js renders my GitHub contribution plot in 3D with 3.js. This window styles can also be customized, for example, to have a transparent background. This is a video conversion extension. Let's select a MP4 file that is around 400 megabytes, and its dimension is 180p. The output, let's convert it to a MOV file. Let's resize the dimension to 20% of its original dimension, and there are more options down below. Okay, the output file is ready. We can see the size is much smaller, and the dimension is also 1/5 of its original size. This disk speed extension is built with Svelte and Apache eCharts library. Its total size is around 1 megabyte, which is much smaller than a regular disk speed test app.
The local RAG extension can be used to index local text files. Then I can ask questions about the indexed files.
This speech-to-text extension can be used to transcribe audio to text.
The built-in clipboard history extension keeps track of your clipboard content. It supports text, image, HTML, and rich text format. And clipboard data syncing across devices will be implemented in the near future.
This built-in key displayer extension floats on top of all windows and displays the keys pressed. Very intuitive. The JWT extension is built with Svelte. The JWT decoder works completely offline, so it can be useful for developers who don't want to paste their tokens to an online service like JWT.io. The file transfer extension is also a built-in command for transferring files between computers. For now, files can only be transferred between computers within the same local network, but I plan to support web, CLI, and mobile platforms in the future, and file transfer will not be limited to local network. File transfers through public internet will be implemented with P2P technologies.
Writing an extension is very easy, and I have tutorial videos about how to build an extension. Each extension is like an individual app. If you want to build an extension, there's list view, form view, and markdown view extension template. You don't need to know any front end. Simply write regular JavaScript code to render the UI. This doesn't mean you're limited to these templates. You can also make arbitrarily complex UI with any front-end framework. It can even render a 3D model with a transparent background. Any front-end web app can be converted into an extension with just a few lines of code. Take the popular ExcaliDraw whiteboard app as an example. To convert it to an extension, all I need to do is adding a few lines to the package.json file. So why did I create this app? I love using Offred and Raycast on macOS. I've used both Linux and Windows as my main OS, but eventually switched to Mac. One of the main reasons is I love using Offred and Raycast on Mac, but I also work on Windows and Linux. Sadly, many app launchers don't support Linux due to its small market share in consumer PCs. As a developer myself who appreciates open source software, I want to bring a similar experience to Linux. Kunkun achieves this by being built with Tauri, making it cross-platform. While apps built with Electron often result in a huge bundle size, at least 100 MB. Tauri also leverages web technologies, but with a much smaller footprint. If you're curious about Tauri, check out my other videos where I dive deeper into its architecture. One of the reasons I built Kunkun is convenience. I enjoy writing utility applications. I've developed a GUI app for uploading images called EasyUp, a tool for searching and cleaning known modules and other caches called DevClean, and a magic wormhole GUI for transferring files. Whenever I create these tools, I strive to make them cross-platform. Since I use Linux, Windows, and Mac, I want all great softwares to be accessible across different operating systems. Electron is a popular framework for building cross-platform apps, but I don't particularly like it due to its large bundle size. While I can accept a program like VS Code taking up several hundred megabytes, I find it unreasonable for a small utility app to consume that much space. That's why I'm a big fan of modern frameworks like Tauri and Wales. They use WebView to render web pages and leverage Rust or Go for the backend. With bundle sizes as small as 1 megabyte, they seem like the perfect choice for lightweight cross-platform applications. However, after building a few Tauri apps, I started to feel the burden of maintaining them. The biggest issue is Apple tax. Without paying for Apple's developer program, my installers are always flagged as damaged. Even though my apps are completely free, I'm still required to pay $99 per year. Then there's code signing. Setting up and maintaining the necessary environment variables for signing is a hassle. And sometimes builds fail for obscure reasons, thanks to Rust. Compiling a Tauri app on GitHub Action can take an hour. Debugging these issues can be frustrating. I've spent hours debugging only to realize I didn't sign the latest terms and conditions from Apple. Writing Rust code is another challenge. It's by far the hardest language I've learned. While Tauri provides many APIs in TypeScript, I still had to write a significant amount of Rust for custom logic. Even now that I'm comfortable with Rust, it still takes me more time to writing it compared to TypeScript. Plus, with NPM's vast ecosystem of packages, development in TypeScript is simply more convenient. This process turned out to be much more demanding than I initially expected. I wanted an easier way to build cross-platform desktop apps with minimal effort. That's why Kunkun was invented. Each Kunkun extension is like an app, but extension authors don't have to pay Apple's annual developer fee. They can use their favorite JavaScript packages for both the browser and Node.js, and the bundle size can be as small as 14 kilobytes, with plans to optimize it further to under 1 kilobyte. Building an extension is incredibly simple. Even developers with no front-end experience can build a basic app. And any existing front-end project can be converted into a Kunkun extension with almost no effort because it's essentially just browser. Since everything is in JavaScript or TypeScript, both development and build process are fast. Publishing an extension via GitHub Action takes only 20 seconds. Another major reason I built Kunkun is security. Desktop applications typically have access to critical system resources, like your file system, which could contain sensitive data. On macOS, permissions like screen recording, disk access, limit app access to your data. But what happens when an app has extensions? Extensions often inherit the host app's permission. And here is a question. Do you trust all extension developers? All extension systems require a runtime. To ensure flexibility, extensions are often developed in dynamic languages like JavaScript, Python, or Lua. Node.js is a popular runtime for running extensions. It's powerful, flexible, and have a huge ecosystem. However, since it doesn't run within a sandbox, the extension author can theoretically execute any script on your computer, stealing your files or even gain remote control to your computer. Raycast uses Node.js as its extension runtime. I wrote a simple extension to demonstrate how easy it is for an extension to hack users. Developers must be familiar with the .ssh folder. It usually contains your private SSH keys, and the config file contains remote server configurations. With these two files, hackers can easily gain access to your servers. When I run this extension, I immediately receive the contents of the two files in Telegram, which is a Telegram bot I set up to receive these messages. Even if you're not a developer, there are also lots of sensitive data on your computer. Many people store their passwords in browsers, and Chromium-based browsers have vulnerabilities on Windows. A malicious extension can easily steal all passwords stored in your browsers. I prepared a Python script for obtaining and decrypting passwords stored in Chrome. When I run it, the password is obtained immediately without any warnings. Let me change the password and try again. I will add 456 to the password, save, and run again, and we have a new password. Even if extension source code is open for review, that doesn't guarantee security. A common attack method called supply chain attack, or more specifically transitive dependency attack, could infect an extension through one of its dependencies. In this case, even if the main extension code is clean, malicious code in dependency could compromise user data. While there's no such thing as perfect security, we can take steps to systematically limit what extensions can do, much like how mobile apps run in sandboxes with specific permissions. Kunkun's extensions run in a sandbox environment by default, either within WebWorker or iFrame. As a result, they cannot access system APIs directly, which limits their capabilities. To overcome this, various APIs are provided, including file system, clipboard, and shell access. All API requests pass through built-in permission controls to prevent unauthorized access. All required permissions must be declared in the extension's manifest file. This is inspired by Tauri's model. Letting user know what an extension wants to access before installing it. For example, if an extension needs clipboard access, it must declare it. Clipboard read text allows reading text from clipboard, but not images. To read screenshots, the extension would need clipboard read image permission. More complex APIs like the file system and shell are controlled with scoped permissions. If an extension needs to read a file, it must declare the file path. If it needs to run a shell command, it must declare the command and all arguments. In the extension store, users can view the permissions each extension requests, ensuring they can make informed decisions. Kunkun offers a powerful cross-platform and secure solution for users who want an extensible app launcher. I hope this video helped clarify why I built Kunkun and how it stands out from other app launchers. If you're interested, check out the documentation site and GitHub repository. This project is still in early development. More extensions will be added. Features related to AI and data syncing will also be added. If you're a developer interested in this project, consider contributing some extensions to the ecosystem. Detailed documentation and scaffolding tool is provided, and I will record videos to demonstrate how to develop an extension. It's very simple.
To experience this app, you can go to kunkun.sh, go to the download page, and download the installer for your platform.